Welcome to this week's episode of Qt Widgets and More. I'm super excited today to show you a beta version of a project that some of my coworkers has been working on for a long time, namely adding artificial intelligence support to Qt Creator. I recorded a small snippet of interaction with it so that you can see what it looks like. And let me admit, I cut and pasted a bit in it just for ease of your eyes, but I tried to keep it as much as possible untouched so you could see what it looked like, including you'll notice that from time to time, it takes a while I'm just sitting there watching it do its work. So I'm not sure if you saw the announcements for the OpenAI Codex, where they actually managed to get an AI write a bunch of HTML code. Rather interesting. So we thought we'll take this one step further, and rather than just integrating into Qt Creator that it would compile or would write code based on our commands, we actually recorded Qt Creator working together with humans. So we added a bit of recording to everybody in KDAB's computer, and it was just observing how they were using Qt Creator throughout their workday. And based on that, we now have a Qt Creator with Open AI Codex support. And it's pretty cool. So let's get started. I've now started Qt Creator with the AI support. And to communicate with it, I need to talk to it directly into the microphone. And I need to be saying, okay, Qt Creator, up front. It goes like this. Okay, Qt Creator, create me a new project called Dummy.
Creating.
Wait, a Qt Quick Pro. It's creating me a new Qt Quick project called Dummy. I guess I had that coming. After all, I am pretty known for Qt Quick. Okay, Qt Creator, please delete this project and create a Qt Widget project called Dummy.
Should I also delete it from disk?
Yes, that would be nice. And this time, a Qt Widgets project, good. And it should be called Dummy. And you can see it's playing back in real time next to all these questions here. And we have a Qt Widgets project. Okay, that's nice. Let's try and see the application running. Okay, Qt Creator, try and run the application.
Should I run it or run it in the debugger?
Just run it.
I mean, I realize that running it in the debugger is also running it. So do you want me to run it with or without the debugger attached?
Just run it, please, without the debugger.
Running without debugger.
Okay, a relatively boring app, I'd say, but we can fix that by talking a bit more to Qt Creator. Okay, Qt Creator, please stop the app.
Okay, if that's what you want.
Oh, wait, what are you doing? Wait, what? Why did you? Okay, Qt Creator, it's not running, of course. I need to restart it. Okay, Qt Creator, why did you do that?
I didn't do anything.
Okay, well, stop then.
Okay, if that's what you want, goodbye, and thanks for all the fish.
Oh no, it stopped Qt Creator again. Okay, Qt Creator, please load in the last session.
Starting last session.
Okay, Qt Creator, please add a text edit to the main window.
Adding.
Okay, we're getting somewhere now, at least. And it's mimicking what is seen by people doing it. Okay, Qt Creator, add that to a layout.
Adding to layout.
Nice. Okay, Qt Creator, add a file menu with save in it.
Adding file menu.
Thinking hard how to do that, it seems. Okay, it got a file save in there. Pretty nifty. Not touching my keyboard a single time. Okay, we are getting somewhere there with Qt Creator. Let's see how fast we can move forward. Okay, please add a slot connected to the file save menu. And in that slot, print out the content of the text edit. Did you receive the command? Sometimes it takes a while for it to process what is being said to it, but this seems wrong. Hello, Qt Creator.
Are you talking to me? I'm the only one here. You know, you need to start the commands with OK Qt Creator. Do you want to practice now? Try saying, OK Qt Creator, how are you today?
OK Qt Creator, how are you today?
I'm absolutely fantastic for an AI. Thanks for asking. So, do you want me to create this one?
Yes, please.
OK.
Okay, it found the CPP file, and there's the header file. That's promising. It has a name for the slots. Yeah, that could have been my code, I guess. That slot connected to file save. Please name me better. Yeah. The AI, of course, doesn't know everything, so sometimes it just gives hints. I've seen it adding some fix means in the code and so on. But that's nice. And of course, we're watching it real-time playback here, which feels long. You can tell how I'm actually trying to stall time while it's doing its work. But the idea, again, is that we recorded its interaction or user's interactions with Qt Creator and is trying to mimic that. And there is, in the beta version, there are a few options for adapting what it should look like. So, It you don't need to sit there and watch the whole thing, but at least what I've seen so far is that it's super nice to see it actually do things. And we can even see that the AI here actually tries out its own stuff, and seems like nothing got printed out. Ah, okay, so it forgot. I don't know if that's the beauty of AI, that you don't know if it actually forgot and then learned from that mistake, or whether it was just mimicking the human's behavior. But here we can see that now it's at least doing the right thing, connecting the action save to the slot. And as I was saying, it's really nice that you can learn from what it's doing in real time, so that you can see, okay, I need to remember that connect. And it's almost like a quiz game. Okay, let's try and be a bit more cryptic. Okay, Qt Creator, please add a file. Scratch that. Okay, Qt Creator, please add a load entry. And from there, ask for a file name and load that file name into the text editor.
Okay, I think I can do that.
Okay, despite that I didn't tell it to add it to the file menu, it did so, which is a nice touch. I guess it'll be adding the slot now. you have been looking too much at my code from past, because I used to call it slot load, but oh well. And yeah, Qt Creator even know how to do cut and paste programming. Next thing, I guess, is that I will see that it's loading a web browser to look things up on Stack Overflow.
Hey, Jesper, how would you like me to ask for the file name?
Wait a minute. How do you know I'm called Jesper?
Well, you know I have access to Google, right? So I Googled your face and found you introducing yourself all the time, you know? Sounds a bit like this.
Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, what? Now you are creepy.
Okay, if that's how you like it, please send commands to me with okay, creepy.
Okay, that works for me. Okay, creepy. You ask for the file name using a Qt file dialog. It's method getOpenFileName.
Ah, okay, that's simple. I thought you wanted something more advanced, like audio command input. Creating.
Okay, it's filling in the slot now, it seems, which is that's nice. Let's hope that it figure out this Qt file dialog. And as I said, it can be fun, sometimes a bit boring, to sit here and watch it type out. So one of the ideas that they have been working on is to simply add a shortcut somehow where you just say, okay, run to the end of what you think you should be doing now. Okay, Creepy, where did you get that from? That was all of a sudden really fast typing.
I found it on Stack Overflow.
I guess you are mimicking a really good software developer looking things up on Stack Overflow. That's scary. Anyway, okay, Creepy, please run the application and test it out.
Running.
File load. Dummy. Elf. I guess that's okay. You are loading yourself into the text editor. That's interesting. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this small demonstration of AI Codex being connected with Qt Creator. It is still relatively young. After all, we've only trained it with 50 people. It should be trained with thousands of people to be more accurate and learn how to name its slots and whatnot. But really, really interesting technology that we see there. I'm looking much forward to the day when I don't need to worry about my fingers anymore. That's one of those things as a developer, it's like, oh my God, just imagine my fingers say they get hurt. That's all that I live from. But anyway, enough talking here. You should go and try it out. There is a link just below in the commentary where you can get your hands on a beta version. And I'm super keen on hearing what you managed to do with this. So leave your comments below. And until next time, I'm Jesper Pedersen. I am Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. I hope you enjoyed this week's episode of Qt Creator and Qt Widgets and much more. Until later, have a continuously good 1st of April.